ODE. This is a subject of your paper 1 UPSC mathematics optional. Topic we are discussing is linear differential equation with constant coefficients. So in ODE, first of all, is a it's very easy subject in the whole syllabus. Hello everyone, myself Shwetnisha. So today we are discussing a topic from ODE. This is a subject of your paper 1 UPSC mathematics optional. Topic we are discussing is linear differential equation with constant coefficients. So in ODE first of all is a it's very easy subject in the whole syllabus. So now if you are still thinking that whether I should take it or not, so you can try with first this subject, ODE, because this is the easiest one. Okay, so I have taken one of the topic, linear differential equation with constant coefficients. We'll discuss few formulas and we'll discuss few questions as well. Let's start. First of all, it's very important to categorize your equations. See, in the whole syllabus of the ODE, there are many kinds of differential equations. So first of all, if you categorize them, if you classify them that this is the kind of ordinary ODE, so you will be able to figure out which method is applied here. If it is of the form where I can see a constant coefficient, so I'll apply this method. If I see variable coefficient, I'll apply that method. So first of all, it's important to classify them, then we'll solve them. Okay, so this is the general equation, general linear differential equation with constant coefficients, where you can see order of the differentiation can be anything here. Y is dependent variable and X is independent variable. This is a nth order degree, and look at these a1, a2 and till an. These are constants, the word constant coefficients. So a1, a2, a3, all these till an, all these are constants. And what is this capital X here? Capital X is a function of X only, Let's see how the solution looks like. Solution is divided into two parts, CF plus PI. So you have to find CF first and then PI, and then join them, add them to get the general equation. CF means complementary function. And PI means particular integral. When we have to find a complementary function, when we have to find particular integral, it depends. Now, in this lecture, I'm only going to discuss the first part, complementary function, which you need only when this capital X is zero. So when you have a function of X as a zero function, then you only need complementary function. That is the solution. Basically, the particular integral is zero in that case. And if you have a non-zero function of this capital X, then you need to find a particular integral. Okay. So let's start. Okay. This is again a working rule for finding CF. Now we know when we need to just find CF. CF will be the general solution if I have capital X as 0. So what it says, it's a general equation. Rewrite the equation in the symbolic form, that is equals to capital X. Find the auxiliary equation. Don't worry, we'll do all these steps in the question, so it will be more understandable there. We change all the capital D to this small m. And what is this capital D? Capital D is the operator. Capital D is operator, d by dx. This is capital D. Okay. And change into auxiliary equation. Find, solve auxiliary equation. Nature of roots of the auxiliary equation will tell you what kind of solution you will have. If you have one real root, m1, only one, then this is the solution. C1 e raised to the power m1x. If you have two real and different roots m1 m2, then c1 e raised to the power m1x plus c2 e raised to power m2x. So now what you have to do, you have to memorize all this table, but don't worry, just go through it and try questions. When you do more and more questions, you again revisit this table, you again see the formula. So eventually you'll be able to learn which kind of roots are giving me what kind of solution in complementary function. Let's start with a question here. Question is, question number one, fourth differentiation minus third differentiation minus 9 coefficients I'm using as constant coefficients, 9 x square minus 11 dy by dx minus 4y equals to 0. Let's solve it. Now, in notation, if I change d by dx as capital D, so it will be d raised to the power 4 minus d raised to power 3 d cube minus 9 d square minus 11 d minus 4 y is common equals to 0. This is the first step. Next step, find auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is, change all the capital D to small m, m raised to power 4 minus m cube minus 9 m square minus 11 m minus 4 equals to 0, solve it. Now obviously solving this is a target, right? It's a fourth degree equation, so we don't have a direct formula or something to find the formulas, to find the root, but don't worry, try with an obvious hit and trial methods. Try with an obvious answer like 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, you know, small numbers. Try with the small numbers first. So if I start with 1 here, let's say, so if I start with m equals to 1, 1 minus 1 minus 9 minus 11 minus 4, I don't see it is going to be equals to 0. You know, 1 minus 1 cancel and it will be some minus of some number, it is not going to be 0. So 1 is not the root. Try with minus 1. Minus 1, so minus 1 raised to the power 4 minus minus 1 cube minus 9 times minus 1 square minus 11 times minus 1 minus 4. I think this is coming out to be 0. It's 1 minus 1 minus 9 plus 11 minus 4. So 1 minus 1 cancel, 9 plus, no, it's not. This is minus of minus 1, it's plus 1, right? Plus 1, minus and plus, yeah, okay. So it's, yeah, 13 minus 13 is going to be 0. So you're getting minus 1 as a root. Still your problem is not solved. Only getting the 1, 0 is not going to help us. It's a 4 degree equation. I need other 3 as well. So whenever you have such a big equation and at least you get one root, so before going to any other number, before going to check 2 or minus 2, check whether this is a repeated root or not. Repeated means sometimes even if I have a quadratic equation, I can have repeated root. I can have 2 and 2 as the root of x minus 2 whole square. It is a quadratic, it doesn't mean that it will have only the two different roots. No? So it doesn't mean that I'll have all the four roots as different roots. How to check repeated root? These small things that I'm telling you, that is not actually the part of the question. A prerequisite kind of thing is required. Please do write it. Make a box, please write it separately that, okay, this is something that we have learned new. So whenever you are going to check that whether a number is a repeated root or not, all you need to do is differentiate. Differentiate it with respect to m. So if I differentiate with respect to m, it will be 4m cube minus 3m square minus 9m minus 11. If minus 1 is the root of this equation as well, is 0 of this polynomial as well, then it's a repeated root. So check 4 times minus 1 cube. So I'll directly write answer here. Minus 4 minus 3 plus 9 minus 11. Right. So it's minus 1, so it becomes, just a second, 4m cube minus 3m square minus 18m, so it's plus 18, right? Yes, so it's 0. It's 0. So yes, it's a repeated root, so I'm getting at least 2 roots, minus 1 and minus 1, 2 more are left. Let's check whether it is again repeated root or not. Differentiate. Differentiate. It's 12m square minus 6m minus 18. It's 12 times minus 1 whole square plus 6 minus 18. Again, it is 0. Getting the point? You do not need any other number. Minus 1 is doing all the job. So, minus 1 so far is repeated root 3 times. Let's differentiate it one more time. 24m minus 6. Now, minus 1 is going to fail us. 24 times minus 1 minus 6 is not going to be 0. It's a negative of some number. So now you need to work on the fourth number. Okay. So at least you are saved. Right? Only one number. So please check whenever you are solving such a big equations. Just check whether you, when you get first to 0, check whether it's a repeated root or not. Okay. So I get 3 zeros here. So m is equals to minus 1 is 0 of the polynomial. So m plus 1 is a factor of the polynomial. How many times? 3 times. M plus 1, m plus 1, m plus 1. So it's m plus 1 whole cube. M cube plus 1 plus 3m square plus 3m. It will definitely divide your polynomial. Polynomial is m raised to power 4 minus m cube, m raised to power 4 minus m cube minus 9m square minus 11m minus 4. Minus 4. Right. So you divide, obviously you will get a linear polynomial here, it will be m minus 4. So, don't need to do any further calculation, 4 is your fourth. Now, go back to your table. You are getting the answer minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and 4. Go back to your table. Table says if you have equal, okay, 3 real and equal, m1, m1, m1. I'm getting minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So, your solution is c1 plus c2x plus c3x square and e raised to the power m1x. So, solution would be I'll write here. Okay, I'll write here. CF is C1 plus C2x plus C3x square times e raised to the power m1x. M1 is minus 1, so minus x. But we cannot forget about 4 also. So we'll have one more. C4 e raised to the power 4x. This is your CF and this is your answer. This is equals to 1. Okay? Because we have a 0 here. So we don't need to find PI. This is how you find CF. So what you did? Represent in the terms of capital D, find auxiliary equation, find the root, which can be sometimes targeting. That is the only thing that I see that can create an issue over here. Once you get the values of m, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and 4, then you can write your solution. Okay, easy? Let's do one more question. Question number 2. Change. Is that the same? Is that the same? No, it's different. Okay. D cube plus 6D square plus 11D plus 6. Y equals to 0. auxiliary equation is m cubed plus 6m squared plus 11m plus 6 is equals to 0. Here you have to find only three roots, but still that's a problem because we don't have a direct formula for that. So we have to try with hit and trial method, m cubed. Okay. Because all the signs are positive, so at least don't try any positive number. It will only give you positive, it cannot cancel out things and cannot give you zero. So at least don't try with the positive numbers. Now, what we can do instead is try with a negative number, right? Let's try with minus one. Try with minus one. Minus one cubed plus 6 times minus 1 square plus 11 times minus 1 plus 6. So minus 1 plus 6 minus 11 plus 6. Cancel out, 0. Check out for the repeated rule. Do the differentiation. Do differentiation. 3m square plus 12m plus 11 minus 1. 3 times minus 1 square plus 12 times minus 1 plus 11. It's 3 minus 12 plus 11, it's not 0. So it's not repeated root. Every time will not get repeated root. Okay, so we have to work on the other numbers as well. So m is equals to minus 1 is my first root. But for cubic, if you get 1, then the next part will be quadratic equation to solve, and that's easy to solve. Okay, so either you can divide to get the quadratic part, you divide by m plus 1. So, if you divide by m plus 1, m cube plus 6m square plus 11m plus 6, get the coefficient. Obviously, remainder will be 0. But there is another method also to do this division. You don't actually have to do the division. That is called synthetic division. In synthetic division, you just equate it with 0. If you are comfortable with this division, then it's fine. No need to learn anything new. But if that seems easy, that is also, that will not waste much of your space as well. So let me just show you synthetic division as well. So you just equate m plus 1 with 0. So value of m is minus 1 and do the division. Write down all the coefficients. 1, 6, 11, 6. 1, 6, 11, 6. It's very easy. It will give you quotient also and it will give you remainder also. Okay. 1 as it is, multiply minus 1 with 1, minus 1, write down minus 1 here. So you multiply this here and write down here. Now next is 6 minus 1, 6 minus 1, 5, multiply minus 1 with 5 now and write here, minus 5, 11 minus 6, 6, again. Multiply minus 1 with 6, minus 6, 6 minus 6, 0. Obviously, remainder has to be 0. It's divisible. So, this is remainder and this is quotient. M square plus 5m plus 6. Therefore, m cube plus 6m square plus 11m plus 6 is equals to m plus 1 times m square plus 5m plus 6. It seems more like I'm solving quadratic equations here, not ODE, right? I'm solving equations. So you see how easy these questions are. If you leave ODE, that will be the stupidest decision you'll make in mathematics also. This is the easiest subject. So what is the value? Minus 2 and minus 3, hana? Minus 1. So you have three different roots. Again, go back to the table and your solution is C1 e raised to power minus x plus C2 e raised to power minus 2x plus c3 e raised to power minus 3x. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 are the solutions. Okay. Again, you just need CF because it's 0. So, I hope that at least use of the table is very clear. Finding the CF is very easy. You just have to solve this equation. That's it for today. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about particular integral as well. Okay. Thank you so much, everyone.